Betsy was thoughtful for a time. Then she remarked, as she looked at the six messengers of light, "We couldn't well do without any of them, could we?" Irma laughed softly. "I couldn't, I'm sure," she replied, "and I think mortals would miss any one of my maidens as well. Daylight cannot take the place of sunlight, which gives us strength and energy. Moonlight is of value when daylight, worn out with her long watch, retires to rest. If the moon, in its course, is hidden behind the earth's rim, and my sweet moonlight cannot cheer us, starlight takes her place, for the skies always lend her power. Without firelight we should miss much of our warmth and comfort, as well as much cheer when the walls of houses encompass us. But always, when other lights forsake us, our glorious Electra is ready to flood us with bright rays. As Queen of Light, I love all my maidens, for I know them to be faithful and true."
"I love 'em, too," declared Betsy. "But sometimes, when I'm real sleepy, I can get along without any light at all."
"Are you sleepy now?" inquired Irma, for the feast had ended.
"A little," admitted the girl.
So Electra showed her to a pretty chamber where there was a soft white bed, and waited patiently until Betsy had undressed and put on a shimmery silken nightrobe that lay beside her pillow. Then the light maid bade her good night and opened the door. When she closed it after her, Betsy was in darkness. In six winks, the little girl was fast asleep. End of chapter 12. Chapter 13. The Jinjin's Just Judgment. All the adventurers were reunited next morning when they were brought from various palaces to the residence of Tititi Hoochoo and ushered into the great hall of state. As before, no one was visible except our friends and their escorts until the first bell sounded. Then, in a flash, the room was seen to be filled with the beautiful kings and queens of the land. The second bell marked the appearance in the throng of the mighty Jinjin, whose handsome countenance was as composed and expressionless as ever. All bowed low to the ruler. Their voices softly murmured, "We greet the private citizen, mightiest of rulers, whose word is law and whose law is just."